It's a story familiar to most Australians, children forcibly removed from their families, supposedly in their best interest. In Switzerland, their own dark chapter in social engineering is now being revealed. For generations, children and teenagers were taken from their parents and forced onto labour farms or even prisons for unwed teen mothers. Now the survivors are fighting for recognition. David Brill went to Switzerland to find out more.
I nearly committed suicide in those times. It was too hard for a teenager.
Ursula Biondi is taking me to the Hindelbank women's prison.
Can you just see the first block here, first floor? I was there. It was in 67 until 68. I was here. I had to live here for about 1 year and 1 week. And this, all these experiences in here marked me for life. It's criminal what they have done with teenagers in those times.
Until 1981, the Swiss state sent thousands of teenagers to places like Hindelbank for re-education. Accused of being rebellious or promiscuous, they were held indefinitely, without trial.
And the reason was because with 17, I was pregnant in the fifth month, and it wasn't allowed then to have children without being married.
And you ended up here?
Yes. For educational reason, for moral reason. This was number 3 there.
Just up there.
I nearly gave birth from my first child in this cell there. At 2 o'clock in the morning, I woke up with a terrible pain in my belly. I was scared, I was terrified, because there was no light.
When the baby arrived, it was taken away. After 3 months of protest, Ursula was finally reunited with her son.
Because I was screaming and fighting all the time, but like a fool, I nearly lost my mind here. Lives damaged and destroyed.
Ursula is far from alone. Hundreds of thousands of children were victims of Switzerland's harsh social policies. Young people who were taken from their homes. Many ended up physically and mentally abused.
Also, da bin ich jeden Tag bin ich da aufgelaufen für die Schule, für die Käserei, im Tag 4-mal und habe einfach das war meine Freiheit.
Hugo Zing is making a painful journey back to the place he once called home. This is the village of Wattenwil, high in the Alps, where Hugo was sent to work when he was just 6 years old.
Da auf dem Bauernhof ist die Religion ist Trischla mit Gurt, mit Zentyro und immer Trischla.
Hugo was a verdingkind, or contract child. one of thousands sent to farms to work. The policy lasted for more than 100 years up until the 1950s.
Der einfach für alles immer Schläge, 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 immer Schläge. Und für alles zu schuld sein.
The abuse went on for a decade. Of the five other Fadin Kinder on the farm, four ended up committing suicide.
Und heute bin ich eigentlich glücklich und zufrieden, dass ich das alles überstanden habe, dass ich niemandem muss Danke sagen.
Going through all these stories is that the lack of love, not being loved, not being part of a family.
Historian Loretta Seaglass has interviewed hundreds of former contract children as part of a touring exhibition about their lives.
Why were the children disregarded in Switzerland?
At the beginning of the phenomenon, it was poverty. Switzerland was a very poor country up until after World War II, and the communities had to look after their poor people. But it was a social disciplinary thought behind it as well, because they wanted poor people, and especially poor children, to learn how to work in order not to become poor again as an adult.
The policy also targeted children from broken homes, single-parent families, or unwed mothers.
The range of what was morally okay until the 1970s was very narrow, meaning if you did not fit detention was one possibility, putting you in a prison or in an institution without having committed a crime.
Outside the exhibition, Albert Elbert is catching up with friends. They're also former contract children. Albert was 3 months old when he was taken away from his 17-year-old unmarried mother.
It was just the problem that we had never lived, the liebe Mutter never seen. Der Vater kennengelernt mit 24 und der hat auch nicht viel wollen wissen. Seine zweite Frau hat auch nichts wollen wissen.
When Albert was only 5, he was sent to work on a farm.
Zum Beispiel, wenn ich am Sonntag in die Kirche musste und die Predigt ablose vom Pfarrer. Und wenn ich heimgekommen bin, musste ich die Predigt dem Bauer erzählen. Und wenn ich es nicht gewusst habe, dann habe ich müssen auf so eine Drückhand Holzscheitern knüllen. Und dann hat er mich mit dem Lederriemen rausgezogen und hat mit dem Lederriemen mich abgeschwartet.
A lot of them still dealing with what they've experienced today. Some had the chance to get professional help, some didn't, some need to talk about it, and it's good for them, others can't talk about it.
Jetzt machen Sie die Türen auf. Jetzt machen Sie doch nicht noch schwieriger für die Türen.
It's been a taboo topic for decades. But now the disturbing story of the Fadin Kinder has been thrust into the public glare with the release of a confronting film on the subject. The Contract Boy had phenomenal success at the Swiss box office. In Zurich, Ursula Biondi wants to introduce me to Maria Magdalena, close friends since they were both imprisoned in Hindelbank. Removed from her family as a child, Maddie, as she's known, had grown up in an orphanage where she was habitually tortured.
Der Kopf ist Wasser, bis du fast verstickt, bis du fast abgesoffen wärst. Wieder raus, weißt du so? Oder? Wieder rein, wieder raus. Das ist stundenlang. was meinst du, man hat über... Du wirst erfinden, du musst... Wie ich gesagt habe, deine Seele muss aus deinem Körper, dass du das dann überhaupt auf die Länge alles kannst mitmachen.
Like Ursula, Maddie was 17 and pregnant when she arrived at Hindelbank. But unlike Ursula, Maddie was forced to give her baby up for adoption.
Ich habe ja die Verarbeitung hinter mir. Das mit daheim, alles, das ist für mich abgeschlossen, mehr oder weniger. Mir hat das gut getan. Aber was ich nicht abschliessen kann, geht einfach um das, dass wir das Leben lang gestraft sein sollten. Uns, wo wir Kind gestohlen haben. Dass eine Behörde, heute noch, ich meine, die Verbrechen, die eine Politik und eine Behörde gemacht hat, das kann es nicht geben.
Also, daher bin ich gekommen, polizeilich, haben sie mich hergebracht, mit Polizeiauto.
One of the most shocking stories I heard was that of Bernadette Gashter. I met her outside Ville Psychiatric Hospital, where she was committed in 1972.
Oder da kommst du auf Ville und stellen dich ruhig mit Medikamenten. Du kommst hinter Gitter. Es ist so entwürdigend, oder? Du badest mit 12 anderen in einer Badwanne, dass jedes Ungeziefer weg ist. Und man nimmt dir alles weg. Du hast gar nichts. Nichts. Du hast von ihnen Hilfe. Überhaupt nicht, oder?
When she was 7 years old, Bernadette's strictly religious foster parents took her to a doctor, believing she was sexually active. She was diagnosed with a brain disorder, and from that point on, her childhood became a nightmare.
Und die ist mir nachher das ganze Leben angehaftet. Und die Pflegeeltern, die haben natürlich das geglaubt, oder? Und anhand von dem war ich ja dann in Zürich bei einem Psychiater und später immer wieder in Wiel. In Wiel, wo man mich am Hirn... Es ist furchtbar, wenn ich daran denke. Eben, man hat mich an so Elektroden rund ums Hirn angesteckt. Und hat mir auch mit so Tröten in die Nase aufgetan und Elektroschocktherapie gemacht, um herauszufinden, ist sie wirklich normal oder ist sie nicht normal, oder?
Bernadette continued to receive treatment until the age of 18, when she fell pregnant. She was brought to this hospital and presented to a room of doctors.
Ja, das ist mir immer vorgekommen. Wie vor dem Richter, als wäre ich ein Schwerverbrecher und hätte jetzt gerade hier umgebracht. Und jetzt muss man die hier befinden, was machen wir jetzt mit dem Schwerverbrecher, oder? Da ist zumal beschlossene Sache, dass ich ja nicht normal bin, dass ich ja geistesgestört bin und einen Hirnschaden habe.
Bernadette was told she was unfit to be a mother. She was committed to hospital. Her baby was aborted and she was sterilized.
Da hat er früher kein Schwein zugelassen. Du bist so allein, eingesperrt. Du hast keine Möglichkeit gehabt, um irgendwo fort.
Last year, Bernadette spoke as a victim of forced sterilization at the European Council in Paris.
Kommission. Und dann haben sie den Kopf geschüttelt. Und ich weiss nicht, sind ihnen fast Tränen gekommen, weil furchtbare Gesichter habe ich gesehen, oder? Und ich habe aber gefunden, ja, es war irgendwie wahnsinnig für mich, oder?
Still we have thousands of people between 55 and 90 or upwards who still are suffering about depression, drugs, alcohols and a lot of victims suicide.
Manche von ihnen verbrachten Jahre.
Switzerland's verding Kinder are waiting for a national apology. But for Ursula Biondi and those sent to prison for so-called immoral behaviour, there has been an acknowledgement of injustice.
Möchte ich Sie im Namen des Bundes in aller Form um Entschuldigung dafür bitten, dass Sie ohne Gerichtsurteil zur Erziehung administrativ versorgt wurden.
Ursula says an apology isn't enough.
The damage is enormous. We, the victims, ask for a historical report and financial compensation.
Is compensation likely?
Compensation is not likely, no.
Why not?
This is a very difficult issue, and all the politicians don't really want to talk about money. So I think if you have injustice being done, there needs to be some kind of reparation.
Bei Hitler hat man das, das ist gesagt, die Leute sind, haben alle eine Möglichkeit bekommen. Wieso können wir das nicht auch bekommen? Unsere Schweiz, wo eigentlich immer das Saubermann muss sein, wo so viel Dreck und Steck geht, was die mit Jugendlichen, mit Kindern alles abzogen, das darf einfach nicht. Das darf es nicht geben. Das darf nicht sein.
It's a program of heartache tonight. Filmed and reported by David Brill. And David talks more on our website about why it's taken so long for this story to become public. There's also extra information on the campaign to gain recognition for those affected. Coming up after 23 years interrogating prisoners, a CIA man reveals just how far they were prepared to go.
There are always troubling things, and the job is to go to the edge of what is acceptable and maybe troubling, but still acceptable.